So I'm going to point out a few research studies about the effects of what we eat and stress. And I'm going to read you something from this great book, How Not to Diet by Dr. Michael Greger, plant-based MD. His other book, How Not to Die, is wonderful also, and it goes over all the research on eating vegetables and natural herbs and different ways that we can actually reduce symptoms of illness or prevent it from food versus medication and the actual research behind it. But often as a yoga teacher or chair yoga teacher, people come to classes for certain needs. They want to sleep better, reduce pain, decrease stress. Maybe they have joint inflammation. They're trying to prevent surgery. And often people want to know what's the yoga pose or breathing technique to do that. And although there are specific benefits to certain yoga poses and sequences and types of yoga, as well as meditation and breathing practice, there's a very important aspect of yogic lifestyle, which is the food we eat. Yoga is not just postures or even just meditation or mind training. But the yogic diet traditionally was vegetarian. Now, for nonviolence reasons and for better health, it's probably, I'd say, vegan, which is no dairy as well as no fish or meat. It's a plant-based whole foods diet with vegetables, fruits, nuts, legumes, and such. So Dr. Greger mentions in the How Not to Die book the effects of stress and what we eat. So I want to read this to you because it's quite important to know that when people come to your yoga class for chair yoga and say, oh, I have joint inflammation, or I have, high blood pressure, what can I do to help from yoga? Know that not just suggesting poses, and as yoga teachers, we're not doctors, so we can't say something is a prescription, but you can share from your experience if you're practicing what works and doesn't work, or what you've learned, and suggest it. They'll have to decide for themselves. So know that the food they're eating and wrapping up your vegetables can reduce inflammation, perhaps even greater than a legs up on the wall pose, or both may be good. Know that getting in touch with your body is one of the benefits of yoga postures, which may help you eat more mindfully and eat more nourishing, what we call in yoga in Sanskrit, sattvic, more pure, wholesome foods to stimulate a healthy immune system, healthy body, and peaceful mind. So the effects of stress is not just from what happens to us on the outside or how we react, but it's from the food we eat. So this section is called the meat of the matter. And Dr. Michael Greger says, a single meal high in animal protein can nearly double the level of the stress hormone cortisol in the blood within a half hour of consumption, more than twice that of a meal closer to the recommended level of protein. Give someone a meal of crab meat, tuna, and cottage cheese, and the level of cortisol in their saliva shoots up within the hour. Instead, give someone barley soup and a vegetable stir fry, and cortisol levels drop after the meal. Imagine eating a meal or dairy meal after meal, day after day. The concern is you might chronically stimulate your adrenal glands. We don't always have control over the stress in our lives, but at least we can make some dietary tweaks to help keep cortisol under control. Chronic high levels of cortisol don't just increase obesity risk. Blood cortisol strongly predicts cardiovascular death in men and women, even among those without known pre-existing cardiovascular disease. This may help explain death from a broken heart, the heightened heart attack and stroke risk in the weeks immediately following after the loss of a spouse. And he goes on to show that that could be from stress increase as well, increasing the stress hormone levels after losing a spouse, perhaps. So he says even that research studies have shown is less. The stress level after losing a spouse is less than the bump you may get for cortisol after eating a high meat diet. So I wanted to point this out for chair yoga and yoga teachers to really understand whether you're eating the yogic diet, the vegan or vegetarian diet or not, really important to understand that yoga is not just about the postures and the meditation, but the diet, the food we're eating, perhaps three meals a day, versus 30 minute of the yoga posture practice is just as important, sometimes more important, to really create a healthy environment for the body, maybe reduce inflammation in joints or prevent some symptoms from getting worse for chronic illness. And wanted to point that out because stress is what a lot of people come to yoga for, but it's not just do this pose or do this relaxation technique and it'll help. Yes, it could, just 10 minutes a day, maybe alternate nostril breathing, slow breathing, some yoga postures, elevating your legs on the wall. These are yogic techniques that most definitely can help reduce the effects of stress, but so can the food we eat. So the yogic diet free from animal products is very beneficial for the health. And again, I'm not in this training telling anyone what to do or how to eat or what you should eat, but I am educating on the yogic benefits, why the yogis were eating this way, in part to create the healthy body, but also to be in harmony with the animals. Now we know that it's also most sustainable for the earth. So even if you eat more vegetables and less animal products and gradually shift to that, your health probably will do better from less, obviously, cortisol and cholesterol and more nutrients from the vegetables. So I hope this was some information that's useful. That's it for this lecture. But if you are interested, I put an optional hour long lecture by this Dr. Michael Greger, who wrote How Not to Die and How Not to Diet. It's in the research and yoga section. It's an optional link, so you don't need to watch it to complete your 35 or so hours on this course. But if you're interested in hearing more, it's really wonderful hearing the research and the science of what we now know, why the yogis were thousands of years ahead of their time, understanding the benefits of plant-based healthy eating. So feel free to also connect with questions, because I am so passionate about this topic. As a lifelong vegetarian and 7 years shifted to mostly vegan, I really felt the experience in my body of vegetarian versus vegan diet, and working with 25 years teaching yoga, helping if students ask, giving ideas for recipes and Thanksgiving, you have recipes in your yogic diet session for holiday meals, because we grew up eating these vegetarian holiday meals, and different ways that people feel will be obstacles to shift to healthier eating or yogic diet. But I can give you tips if you're curious, because I love helping people know that it's not as challenging as people think to shift. And now in the modern age, we have access to so many wonderful, healthy, vegan and vegetarian substitutes and non-dairy milks. And there's lots of easy ways to shift. So even if you don't want to shift fully, but you just want to eat healthier, that is one step at a time for healthier yogic eating. So I support you, and you can connect with me personally on this if you want to know more as well. Enjoy your healthy meals after your active yoga classes and your meditation, and a little bit of all of that every day can really help you feel better. Have a great day. Namaste.